Welcome to this lecture of Dynamics of Machine. Today we are going to cover two complicated topics, one correction couple, another inertia torque. These two topics always remains confusing, as well as whenever we try to solve a problem of inertia torque, we always get confused when we have to make the direction of different torques. So here I am showing a picture of a system of piston cylinder assembly which we use for engines, and actually we are ultimately trying to get the dynamic conditions or dynamic which we use for our automobile engines. So here the piston is connected with a connecting rod, and then it is connected with a crank. And the most complicated part in this entire assembly is your connecting rod, because the motion of the connecting rod is the combination of rotation as well as the reciprocation. While we make a simple model of this complicated motion of connecting rod, some correction has to be applied in the system, and using those correction finally we calculate the inertia torque. So in this entire session, briefly cover the angular acceleration of connecting rod, then how to decide the direction of the angular acceleration of connecting rod, then briefly we will see the dynamic equivalent system. Finally, we will talk about correction couple, concept of inertia torque, and then we will see the numerical. So let's start with the angular acceleration of the connecting rod. Here is your piston cylinder assembly, and if I am assuming that the crank is rotating in the clockwise direction with a constant angular velocity omega, at the given state the crank is already turned by an angle theta from the horizontal line. So we define two points. The innermost point is the IDC, that is inner dead center, and the outer point is the ODC, outer dead center. So the crank has turned by an angle theta, and at the same time the connecting rod has already turned angle beta from the horizontal position, and piston has moved from its extreme left position to some distance in the rightward direction. Now if you want to write formula for the angular velocity and acceleration of this connecting rod, you can make this triangle. This triangle showing that this is angle beta, this is angle theta, crank is rotating by amount omega, length of the connecting rod is L, length of the crank is defined by radius R, and if I will differentiate the angle beta with respect to time, I will be able to get the angular velocity of the connecting rod. Here I am not going to derive the entire formula. If you are interested, you can watch my other video. Here we are briefly covering the acceleration and the angular velocity of connecting rod. So when you will differentiate the beta, you will get angular velocity. You will further differentiate the angular velocity, you will get the angular acceleration. Here is the formula for the angular velocity: omega cos theta divided by under root n square minus sine square theta. N is the ratio of the length of the connecting rod to the length of the crank. Omega is the angular velocity of the crank, and theta is angle turned by the crank. Similarly, acceleration formula having a negative sign. And now it is very important to understand the physical significance of negative sign. In case of connecting rod, counterclockwise rotation considered positive. So the first thing we can understand from this formula, that if there is a negative sign, that means its direction is clockwise. We must understand that why the direction of the acceleration is clockwise, even though the connecting rod is rotating in the counterclockwise direction. So to understand that, let's understand the motion of your connecting rod. Suppose a link is pinned at this end and rotating in the counterclockwise direction with angular velocity omega and having a positive angular acceleration. Positive angular acceleration means its angular velocity increasing with respect to time. In such condition, if you want to define the direction of your angular acceleration, the angular acceleration will be in the same direction of the rotation because it is having a positive side. Similarly, if the link is rotating in the same direction but with some retardation, the direction of angular acceleration is opposite, or we will say that it is negative. So either we write the negative angular acceleration, or we can define the direction of the angular acceleration will be opposite to the direction of the rotation. Similarly, if I will break the entire motion of connecting rod in four sections. First, when the crank rotates from 0 to 90 degree. When the crank will rotate from 0 to 90 degree, the connecting rod, if I am currently focusing only rotational motion, connecting rod will move from this position to this position. And if I will see the motion, the velocity is reducing and reaching to a zero value, because at this point the angular velocity will be zero and then it will reverse the motion. So here I don't know what is the angular velocity, but it is for sure that angular velocity is reducing while the connecting rod is moving from this mean or horizontal position to the extreme position. That means the retardation. So the direction of angular acceleration will be opposite to the motion, that will be clockwise. Therefore we are having a sign of negative while we are working within the range of 0 to 90 degrees. Then connecting rod will move from extreme position towards the mean position by the time the crank will rotate from 90 to 180 degrees. So in this case the connecting rod will move from here to here. During this motion the velocity is increasing, so omega was 0 here and here some value will be there. So this rotation is actually increasing angular velocity, that means the positive angular acceleration. So here also the direction of the angular acceleration will be clockwise. That means the sign will be negative. And you can cross check when you will go back and you will see the formula of angular acceleration. It is having a sine theta value, and sine theta is positive from 0 to 90 as well as 90 to 180. So for both the cases, you are actually, this negative sign will remain there and the direction of angular acceleration will be clockwise. Further, you will consider the motion of the crank from 180 degree to 270 degree. That means the connecting rod is now moving from mean position to the extreme lower position. Here also the angular velocity is reducing, because I know that at the extreme position the angular velocity is again going to become zero. So this is retarding motion. That means the direction of the angular acceleration will be opposite to the motion, or I will say it is counterclockwise. If you are going to put a theta value between 180 to 270 degree in the formula of your angular acceleration, your actually sign will become positive. So that is also showing by looking the motion of the connecting rod, that's when the crank will rotate from 180 to 270 and then from 270 to 0 degree, the direction of the angular acceleration will be counterclockwise direction, and for the 0 to 180 degree it is clockwise direction. And therefore we are having a negative sign up to 0 to 180, and from 180 to 270 and from 270 to 360 it will have a positive sign, or the sense will be counterclockwise direction. And why it is important to understand the direction of the acceleration of the connecting rod? Because later on we have to understand the direction of the correction couple. So later on we will again come back to this acceleration and we will try to find the direction of the correction couple. Second important concept is the dynamically equivalent system. So in case of a dynamically equivalent system, what we do, suppose we are having a body of arbitrary shape. Here the centroid of the body, the mass of the body is m, and the moment of inertia of the body about the centroidal axis, about a polar axis or the axis perpendicular to plane, is defined by the I. So I can write that I is mass of the connecting rod multiplied by k square, where k is the radius of gyration of this body. I am applying a force F at a distance E, perpendicular distance E, from the centroid. Because of the force F, the body is going to subject some effect like acceleration as well as the rotational acceleration or the angular acceleration. If I want to make an equivalent system of this body by breaking the entire body into two point masses, so what would be the value of these point masses as well as what would be the position of these two point masses with respect to the entire system? If I want to keep the same dynamic effect, I can decide that the acceleration of the body will remain constant before and after the changing in the system. Means earlier I am having the entire body distributed mass like I am showing here. Later I want to make it two point masses, but acceleration before and after of the entire system should remain same. That means if I will write the Newton's formula, I know that the force is equal to mass into acceleration. Here the force is an external agent, that means I am not going to control the force. and I want to keep the acceleration constant. So these two condition is only possible if the mass will remain constant before and after the changing in the system. It gives me one formula, that is the mass of the system, that is m, will be the sum of m1 plus m2. So this is first essential condition to maintain a dynamically equivalent system. Second condition is that the moment will remain same, that means it is related to the position of the centroid. So the second condition says that the CG remains at the same position, and if the CG remains at the same position, that is possible if after changing the system into an equivalent system, the entire moment about this point should remain zero, because the definition of the centroid is that entire moment about the centroid will be zero. So here also, if I am saying that the force of this mass is m1g, force of this mass m2g, I will take the moment. So let's consider that this is a distance A and this is a distance B. So m1a is equal to m2b, because this will have a counterclockwise effect and this will have a clockwise effect. To remain the centroid at the same position, I have to follow condition m1a is equal to m2b. So the second condition, which is essentially required to keep the centroid at the same position, that is m1a is equal to m2b. Now the third condition, if we want to keep the same angular acceleration, that means I alpha is going to be balanced by Fe, as F and E are the external agent, external quantity which I cannot control. Alpha I want to maintain same before and after. So the only condition which required is now the I should be same. So the moment of inertia of my body before and after about the centroid will remain same. That means I will have the third formula, that is I about the CG, or I can write it that entire mass K square is equal to moment of inertia, because of the first mass, it is a point mass, and I have to take the moment of inertia about this point, that means ma square plus m2b square. When I will further rearrange this formula considering first two condition, I get a final formula, that is k square is equal to ab. So this is my third condition. I can either use this formula or this condition, both are same. So if I will be able to maintain these three conditions, my system will remain dynamically equivalent. Whatever dynamic effect I am observing for this body, the same will be observed by the equivalent system. And where we are going to use it, we are having a complicated shape of our connecting rod. So to make the mathematical model simple, what we can do, we wish to break the connecting rod into two masses. One mass we want to keep on the piston, another mass we want to keep on the crank, so that the system will become simple. But here there is a problem. If I will make a dynamically equivalent system of the connecting rod and I want to maintain these three conditions, there is a problem that I cannot fix both the distance. What I want to convey, suppose I want to make a dynamically equivalent system of this rod. So what I can do, I can fix one distance. Say I want to put one mass at this position. So I am going to fix this distance, let's A1. Based on this A1 and using these three formulas, I can calculate the mass at this point, I can calculate the other distance of, and then I can calculate the second mass. So by taking only one value, I will be able to get the value of my M1 and M2 as well as the B1 value. Otherwise, if I will initially try to fix A1 and B1 both, I will get some M1 and M2 value, but I will not be able to fulfill the third condition, that is the K square is equal to AB. Because if you are going to fix AB, that is difficult, that you are going to follow the third condition. And you are making it such a way that this AB is equal to K square, there will be a problem with the second condition. So normally it is in our hand that we can fix only one distance, but we cannot fix both the distance. So what happened when we try to make our mathematical model considering this dynamically equivalent system? So this is our piston cylinder arrangement, and if we are following the dynamically equivalent system, what we want, we wish to put two masses at the two end, but dynamically equivalent system says if you are going to fix this A distance, the second mass will not be at this end. You will get it somewhere in between these two points. So you will get a value B1 here. On the other end, if you are going to fix B distance, your second distance will not be A, you will get it between these two points, so it is your A1 distance. Since I am not able to put the two masses at the two ends, at this point, let me tell you, this is all these things are in mathematics only. The actual system doesn't have any problem. There is a connecting rod connected and the forces are transmitting from piston to the crank. But when we want to do it mathematically, how to make a mathematical model which is viable? From using that model, you can solve it and you can get the right answers. And for that purpose, we are developing all these concepts. Cannot make the mathematical model directly by taking the dynamically equivalent system. Then what happened? In our case, this is the system and this is the actually derived system from the dynamically equivalent system, but I am taking my two masses at the two end, so I am making my system little bit deviated from the actual condition, so I have to add something or I have to do some correction in my system, and that gives the correction couple. So what is happening actually? To understand that, let's take a very simple example. Suppose I am having a mass written there at the 5 kilogram, moving with acceleration 10 meter per second, and I have to find the force. But later on, I found that the actual mass is 4 kilogram. So what is happening here? Here, some correcting force is there. And what is the value of that correcting force? So the difference in the two masses, m written minus m actual is 1 kilogram. System is moving with acceleration 10. So I know that some correcting force here is of 10 Newton. Now I want to find what would be the direction of this correcting force. So the magnitude of the correcting force is what? The magnitude of correcting force will be the acceleration and the difference of the two mass. Similarly, if I will write the equation, what I can do? I can check two cases. This is the external force. This is my mass. Suppose the correction direction I will assume in this way. And magnitude of this is 10 Newton. What would be the value of F? From the Newton's law, that all the forces will be going to be balanced by mx double dot, but the direction of the force which are in the same direction of acceleration will be positive, opposite will be negative. So my equation will be what? M means 5 into 10, force which are in the direction, that means the unknown force F, and this is opposite, so minus 10. So ultimately I will get the force will be 60 Newton, but this is not the case. My force is of 40 Newton and 10 Newton is the additional. That means this is not the right way. What I need to do, I have to apply the correcting force in the same direction as the direction of my acceleration. So please remember that this is your external force, this is your correction force, and the direction of the acceleration is forward. When you will solve this system, the external force will automatically comes out 40 Newton. It gives me an indication that the direction of this correcting force will be same as the direction of the acceleration of the body. Similarly, in case of connecting rod, if you are making some error or you are intentionally changing the system, you have to add some correction on your system, and the direction of the correction will be same as the direction of the acceleration of your body. In case of connecting rod, this is my system where one end of connecting rod is at the piston and another one is at the crank. And I wish to break the connecting rod into two masses such that one mass will be on the piston position and another mass should be on the crank end position. However, when I am actually applying the logic of your dynamically equivalent system, the dynamically equivalent system equations indicate that the second mass should be here if you are keeping this distance at the fixed distance. So this is my A. From the dynamically equivalent system formulas, I will get that the second mass should be at a distance B1. However, I am keeping my mass at distance B. So I can take another way, that the entire length of the connecting rod is, let's L. And from the dynamically equivalent system, the position of the second mass with respect to the piston should be smaller. Now what is actually happening? If I will calculate the moment of inertia for dynamically equivalent system, that will be written as M, let's K1 square. And K1 is what? K1 square will be the product of distance A and B1. We have already seen from the dynamically equivalent system. that in case of we are keeping two masses away, the radius of gyration, square of the radius of gyration of the system will be the product of distance A and B. On the other hand, if I will take the modified moment of inertia, that I can write as IK2 square, where the K2 will be what? The K2 will be your A and B. In this case, what is happening? The I dash value is greater than I value, and this is exactly same which I have explained you with a simple mass moving with 10 meter per second acceleration, and its actual value is 4, but we are using a value of 5. So here, what is the difference? The total difference will be I dash minus I, and that has to be multiplied by the angular acceleration of my connecting rod. So the correction torque will be the difference of these two value, I dash alpha minus I alpha. When I will put I value from these two equation, I can rewrite my equation as M A alpha B minus B dash. Or further, I can simplify it and I can get equation M A alpha L minus L. So please remember this formula. This is the formula for the correction couple. Now the next important thing is how to find the direction of this correction couple, because now we are using a mass at crank end as well as the piston end. The direction of the correction couple will be same as the direction of the acceleration of your body. In this case, direction of the angular acceleration of your body. We know that in case of connecting rod, the direction of the angular acceleration is what? The direction of the angular acceleration while we are moving from 0 to 90 degree is clockwise. So it will try to reduce the angle beta. So the same direction will be of your correction couple. So this is the direction of the correction couple, and your connecting rod is moving from this position to this position. So what is actually this del T is doing? It is trying to reduce the angle beta. Well, when the connecting rod is moving from this position to this position, or the crank at the same time is moving from 0 to 90 degree. When it is moving from 90 to 180 degree, again the direction of your acceleration is towards the mean position. So this is the direction of the alpha. So same the direction of the correction couple. When it is moving from 180 degree to 270 degree, it means crank is moving. The direction of your acceleration is what? That this is the crank, connecting rod is moving in this way, but it is retarding. So actually the direction of the acceleration is this way. So the direction of the correction couple will also in this way. What is happening again? We are reducing the angle of the connecting rod. And finally, when it is moving from 270 to 360, we are having the same direction again. So in all the cases, what we can observe, we can find that every time the correction couple is trying to reduce the angle beta, and its direction is always same to the direction of your acceleration of your connecting rod. In the first case, it is actually a retardation. So instead of putting a negative sign, I am putting the direction that is towards this mean position or the clockwise. So these two cases clockwise, for the these two cases it will be counterclockwise, and every time del T is going to follow the alpha. So del T will always try to reduce the angle beta, and this is an important objective problem for many competitive exams. So please remember the formula of the correction couple is mass of connecting rod, angular acceleration of connecting rod, then one position A. A is what? A is the position of the centroid to the piston point. And then we are having L minus L. So please remember this formula. This is the formula for your correction couple. In the next class, we will start the concept of inertia torque. We will try to cover the entire concept, and then we will see the numerical problem. Till then, thank you.